God, most holy, glorious, and undivided Trinity.
And blessed be God's reign now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Maker of marvels, you weave the planet and all its creatures together in kinship. Your unifying love is revealed in the interdependence of relationships in the complex world that you have made. Save us from the illusion that humankind is separate and alone, and join us in communion with all inhabitants of the universe. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who topples the dividing walls by the power of your Holy Spirit, and who lives and reigns for you forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from Genesis. Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. I establish my covenant with you, then never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." God said, "This is the sign of the covenant that I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for all future generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between you and me and every living creature of all flesh, and the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth." Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Psalm 36, verses 5 through 10. Your steadfast love, O Lord, extends to the heavens, your faithfulness to the clouds. Your righteousness is like the mighty mountains. Your judgments are like the great deep. You save the humans and animals alike, O Lord. How precious is your steadfast love, O God. All people may take refuge in the shadow of your wings. They feast on the abundance of your house, and you give them drink from the river of your delight. For with you is the fountain of life, is your light, we see light. Oh, continue your steadfast love to those who know you, and your salvation to the upright of heart.
A reading from Colossians. Jesus is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him, all things in heaven and on earth were created, things visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers. All things have been created through him and for him. He himself is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have first place in everything. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, by making peace through the blood of his cross. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
We'll sing hymn 516, hymn 516.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In late June 2014, my husband Ed and I took a river cruise from St. Petersburg to Moscow. This trip was a rare getaway from home, family, and work to celebrate our 20th wedding anniversary. Unexpectedly, my youngest mom of 74 years died a week before the trip was to begin. She came down with a viral sore throat, which quickly escalated into other problems. And despite her doctor's belief that she was on the road to recovery, she instead was abruptly called home. Ed and I worried about taking this trip, yet decided to go ahead with it because I believe my mom would have blessed us to go. My mom was a Russophile who had visited the Soviet Union and Russia many times. While on that trip on the beautiful Svir River near the historic fishing village of Mandrogi, a double rainbow appeared. This is a photo of that rainbow that I took from the boat. To me, it was a comforting sign, a bridge between my mom in heaven and me in Russia, in Matushka Rus, Mother Russia. I imagined my mom was at the heaven side of the rainbow, free, restored to health, and celebrating God's glory with all the saints and angels, while I looked up from the gravity-bound boat where my earthly journey continued. In the Genesis flood story, God creates a rainbow. Prior to the flood story and creation of the rainbow, the triune God, God the Father, God the Son, the Word, and Ruach, the Holy Spirit, together in collaboration, like a fabulous three-piece jazz band, poured out love to create darkness and light, day and night. The dome in which water, sky, and dry land reside, vegetation and the sun and stars, and sea and land creatures, humankind in God's own image, and finally, the Sabbath, in which to rest and reflect upon the glory of creation. God created the world for his glory out of love, and declared all creation good. Humankind is created in God's image to glorify God. When human beings glorify God, they arrive at the fulfillment of what they are intended to be. Theologian Jürgen Moltmann writes that creation is a Trinitarian process. The Father creates through the Son in the Holy Spirit. The created world, therefore, is created in fellowship by God, formed through God, and exists in God. The Gospel of John and the hymn from Paul's letter to the Colossians that we read today point to Jesus Christ's presence with God at the very beginning of creation. John writes, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him." Paul writes, "In him all things in heaven and on earth were created, visible and invisible. All things have been created through him and for him. In him all things hold together." Thus, Jesus Christ dwells and participates in God's creation and salvation of the world, and later becomes manifest in creation in the incarnation. The inner secret of creation, writes Moltmann, is the indwelling of God in all creation. Creation's goal and future ultimately arrive at the transfiguring indwelling of the triune God into his creation, which through that indwelling becomes a new heaven and a new earth. Human beings hope that in the kingdom of glory, God will dwell entirely and wholly forever in his creation and will allow all the beings he has created to participate in the fullness of his eternal life. Early in the creation story, humankind's fellowship with God is broken and their participation in the fullness of life ends when Adam and Eve eat from the tree of knowledge. A downward trend of corruption and wickedness follows. Let's refresh creation and wash away the sin and corruption God may have thought to himself or herself. So God sent a flood to cleanse the earth. After the flood ends, God makes a covenant with Noah to never again cut off all flesh by the waters of a flood. In essence, God gives creation a fresh start. Using the same language heard earlier in creation, God encourages Noah and his family and all the creatures from the ark to be fruitful and multiply. God creates a rainbow to serve as a sign of God's covenant with Noah and every living creature for all generations that will remind God of my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh, that the water shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. The rainbow is a sign God creates for himself of the unconditional covenant he makes with Noah and all future generations of the earth to remember to never again cut off life by the waters of a flood. The rainbow is also a visual revelation of God to humankind and to all living creatures. It is a sign of salvation, a sign of God's promise to humankind to preserve life. And it is a precursor of work, of action. Rainbows appear after the drama of storms. Then it's time to sweep up the broken tree branches and leafy debris, to clean up flooded basements and homes and streets, and to restore health and order, which the storm's chaos disassembled. God's revelation provides wisdom and confers community and fellowship with humankind. To Adam and Eve, God was revealed by his voice and the sound of his presence walking in the garden. To Moses, first in a burning bush and later in a dense cloud upon Mount Sinai. To the Israelites in the wilderness, God was revealed in a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of light by night. Perfect communion and fellowship with God is achieved in the Word, the incarnation of Christ. Through Jesus Christ, perfect fellowship with God is possible. Right now, I think we are really struggling to live in fellowship with God and with each other. The smoke-filled skies in California and Oregon, the burned refugee camp on the Greek island of Lesbos, obscure God's light and reflect an ecological crisis, a significant disregard for God's creation. The COVID crisis created economic and political chaos and produced suffering, grief, and death all around the globe. Political leaders struggle to govern wisely. Their weaknesses and disunity sow confusion and chaos. Although we may feel discouraged and tired from these stormy, uncertain times, God reminds us that in God, there is always hope and salvation. We have seen many double rainbows over the last several months. One was seen over the Capitol in May when Representative John Lewis lay there in state, which Nancy Pelosi interpreted as a sign communicating that Mr. Lewis was in heaven. Let us turn our full attention to the triune God and find rest, strength, courage, and patience in God. Let us become rainbows in our own families and communities, bringing light and love, bridging the gaps between the haves and the have-nots, healing the suffering, feeding the hungry, clothing the naked, and encouraging the depressed. We are made in God's image and have been given the responsibility to participate in creation here and now in this place. Plan how you will bring comfort to a sad or lonely person, or how you will distribute food to the needy. God empowers and blesses us with the tools and gifts to be co-creators. Our prayers, our actions, and our promises to love and to care for all of creation and the earth produce beautiful rainbows that link God's kingdom in heaven with God's creation on earth. Amen.
The Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son she has worshiped and glorified. She has spoken to the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sin. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us confess our sin against God and God's creation.
Holy and merciful God, we confess that we have failed to honor you by rightly claiming our kinship with all your creatures. We have walked heavily on your earth, overused and wasted its resources, and taken for granted its beauty and abundance. Our privilege shields us from many of the current consequences of climate change, while the economically vulnerable bear the brunt of increasingly extreme natural disasters. Have mercy on us and forgive us our sin. Renew in us the resolve to keep and conserve our earth as you desire and intend, with grateful and compassionate hearts, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen.
People. Let us pray for the revealing of the reign of God in the world now and always. In the beginning, God was. Here and now, God is. In the future, God will be. Creator of earth, sea, and sky, kindle the fire of your spirit within us so that we may be bold to heal and defend the earth, and pour your blessing upon all who work for the good of the planet. Breath of life, receive our thanks for the beauty of our local habitat and all who dwell in it, and grant us the wisdom and will to conserve it. Source of life, heal and redeem the wounds of your creation, and visit the places and people who suffer from our indifference, neglect, and greed. We pray for all those affected by natural disasters, and in particular for those affected by wildfires, flooding, and storms. Author of the Book of Nature, receive our gratitude for places of restoration and healing, and continue to bless those places that feed our lives and spirits. Divine Physician, heal our communities, especially those where neglect, greed, or violence inflict suffering upon others and creatures. Comfort of the earth, sustain the people of this congregation who desire or need your presence and help, especially George, Jim, Roger, Myrna, Don, Sandy, Sue, and all those we think of in this moment of quiet. Rock and refuge of all your creatures, receive into everlasting mercy all those who have died. Eternal God, the light of all who you know, come and fill our hearts with your love. Help us speak when many keep silent. Help us stand for what is right when many sit in indifference. Increase our faith and charity until your kingdom comes and heaven and earth rejoice in everlasting glory. Through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hello, St. Luke's. Today I will be showing you what God's creation is and how we can stop the world from polluting and making God's world better. And we want to make God's world better and stop the polluting. So right now we have here our little polar bear, and she used to have so much ice, and but now look at all that ice, it's all gone now. There's only like 4 pieces left of ice now. And what that happens when people pollute in the water, when they either throw trash or something in the water, that hurts the environment. So we want you to stop, if you pollute, or next time you have a choice, always choose maybe a metal straw or something so you don't harm this beautiful world. Another thing is that here we have a villager, and he has a super nice house, right? And he's like super cool, but then when storms come because of climate change and everything, it can ruin someone's house just like that. And that'll cause them to move out of the house. And some of them may not have the money to afford another house. So they'll have to go somewhere to stay, with like at a friend's house or in a camp. So what can you do to prevent all this stuff from happening and try not to pollute and remember God's creation? And now before I go, I would like you to join me in prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, save God's creation. Bye.
News of Christ's liberating love to all people. Divest your hearts and wallets from the forces of evil in this world that draw you from.
Dismantle white supremacy and all systems that keep you from care of neighbor, and live into the future reign of God breaking in at this very moment. Amen.
Amen.